Yo, Brollies, what's up? I don't know if you know this, but I've been slowly transitioning to the other side since I got my very first iPhone last year. There's something about Apple products, their software, and ecosystem that makes you really get deeper into it. With that said, I'm gonna start by sharing with you my portable 4K video editing setup using the iPad Pro featuring the Acasis 10-in-1 USB hub. The Acasis CM073 is a 10-in-1 USB hub with pretty much all the necessary input and output ports that you'll ever need, with a very nifty feature up its sleeve: an integrated M.2 SSD slot, making it arguably the best USB hub for the iPad Pro and other portable devices. Essentially, you can edit videos off of this external device while also connecting all of your peripherals. With that being said, let's get into it. Alright, so my setup is actually quite simple and revolves around the 2021 iPad Pro. By the way, if you're interested to get some Apple products, my trusted shop here in the Philippines is Beyond the Box, where I got my iPhone 13 Pro Max and the Apple Watch Series 7 last year, and where I intend to get the new MacBook Air M2 once it's available. Now, as much as I want the Apple Magic Keyboard, I really can't justify the price, so I'm just using my favorite low-profile wireless mechanical keyboard, which is the Nufi Air 6T. And to partner with that, I also use a Lenovo Go wireless mouse. These two peripherals support multi-device connectivity, which is perfect whenever I switch between my portable setup and my main workstation. And to make things easier and ties everything together, I'm using the Acasis 10-in-1 USB hub with an integrated SSD slot. This setup might not be as portable and easy to carry compared to the all-in-one Apple Magic Keyboard, but at least I didn't have to spend 17,000 pesos. But to be honest, I'm still considering it. Now, before I share with you how I actually use the setup for my 4K video editing workflow, let me share with you a quick unboxing experience of the Acasis 10-in-1 USB hub so that you can have an idea of what it offers, and I actually get a lot of questions about it, so let's get into it. The packaging is very simple. We have an image preview of the product as well as some of its key features. It is available in 3 different colors, and we also have all the information we need here in terms of its input and output ports, but I'll also overlay it on the screen for a better view for you guys. Inside the box, we have the Acasis 10-in-1 USB hub itself, nicely protected, and we even have a nice silicone casing here, which is pretty awesome, especially if you're going to stow this away inside your bag and what have you. Aside from that, we have the user manual with clear instructions and illustrations. And before I forget, let me pop the size compatibility chart for the M.2 SSD slot. We also have a thermal pad here and a couple of plastic locks. And lastly, we have a short USB Type-C to Type-C cable. Now, at first look and touch, the Acasis 10-in-1 USB hub feels durable and made out of CNC aluminum housing, which in theory should also help dissipate the heat. Looking from the top, every input and output ports are conveniently labeled, making sure you take advantage of the ideal bandwidth for your needs with up to 10 GB per second speed for the two USB 3.1 ports. On one side, we have Gigabit Ethernet and an HDMI port that supports up to 4K 60Hz external display. On the other side, we have the USB Type-C port for connecting this to your host device, a small LED indicator, and a power delivery USB Type-C port that supports up to 100 watts and provides output power to your host device up to 80 watts. This essentially allows you to charge your host device while also providing enough power to all of your peripherals, especially the integrated external storage. At the bottom, we have a couple of rubber feet to keep this thing stay in place. Without an SSD, it weighs roughly just around 141 grams, which is relatively lightweight. I also like the fact that the SSD cover features a toolless design, and all you have to do is snap it off like so to get access to the M.2 slot. Again, this supports multiple form factors of M.2 SSDs with 4 different locking slots. Super convenient, as you can see here, and we even have a free thermal pad for better heat dissipation. Overall, I honestly feel like this is one of the best, if not the best, USB hub for any portable devices out in the market. Now, this allowed me to purchase the cheapest iPad Pro with only 128 GB of internal storage. And this USB hub actually supports up to 8TB SSD, which is absolutely insane. And thanks to LumaFusion's ability to edit videos off an external device, this makes everything work flawlessly and the experience is very smooth. As you can see, once I plug in the Acasis USB hub and hit the external drive refresh button, my project and all of its video clips are immediately available again. In terms of performance, without even looking at any benchmarks, as you can see, scrubbing through my 4K timeline is super fast without any significant or even noticeable stuttering, which is just insane, and this is something that we also have to give credit to the LumaFusion software. It is just super lightweight and smooth compared to, let's say, Adobe Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve, while still providing all the bare essentials anyone needs for a video editing software. Granted, it still lacks some features that other software has, but personally, everything I need is here. Also, once you connect the Acasis USB hub, it will show up inside the Files app, making it super easy to manage and organize your assets. I just need to figure out the best file system to use, as currently, my NVMe SSD is still in NTFS, so it's currently on read-only mode, and I cannot put files directly on it from my iPad. I think I need to convert it to exFAT if I'm not mistaken. By the way, I can also connect my iPad Pro to my ultrawide monitor using the HDMI port on the Acasis USB hub if I want to, but honestly, until Apple released the iPad OS 16, giving us an option to actually use an external monitor with the iPad property, I'm just not gonna use it for now. Alright, so here's a quick speed test for those of you who are interested in numbers, but honestly, based on my real-world experience, the transfer speeds are good enough for my needs. And lastly, if ever I want to switch back to my main desk setup, all I have to do is connect the Acasis USB hub, and I can now use the same peripherals and have access to my NVMe SSD. That's absolutely perfect. I'm trying to learn DaVinci Resolve now since I really want to get off that Adobe Creative Suite subscription. Overall, I'm really happy that I can edit exclusively using just my iPad whenever we are traveling and use the same peripherals and storage device on my main workstation whenever I get back home thanks to the Acasis 10-in-1 USB hub. Perfect! And there you have it guys, thank you for watching. Huge thanks to Acasis for sending this in, you can get this using the link below. Again, if you're interested in some Apple products, Beyond the Box is my trusted store. Thank you for watching, subscribe if you like this, and see you next time. Have a great day guys, you're awesome.